Amen. The songwriter. Jesus. Praise the Lord. Thank God for that song. Amen. As often I make this statement, I wish I could sing it the way I feel it. Praise the Lord. But some people are only gifted by God to sing so well.
All right, Bishop.
Praise the Lord. But I thank God for my little space in the Lord when it comes to singing. I wish if I could sing like others can, but I do have a mouth, and at least I can open up my mouth and try or attempt.
That's right.
Amen. To sing praises unto the Lord for the Lord's glory and for his honor. We thank God for blessing us once again to be back in the house of the Lord. Amen. Thanking him for his grace and his mercy. Amen. I'm grateful to the Lord for all things that the Lord has done for each and every one of us. For a few minutes, that's still. Lord shall lead. We always, as always, pray to God that he will allow the Holy Ghost to glorify Jesus, and always allow Jesus, amen, to be the center of the Word of God. But call your attention today to the book of Mark, chapter number 9.
Bless him, Lord.
Mark, chapter number 9. I will read verse 14 through verse 24.
Thank you, Lord.
Mark chapter 9, amen, verses 14 through 24. And you have it, amen. You can say, what a friend we have in Jesus.
What a friend we have in Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
And when he came to his disciples, he saw a great multitude about him, and the scribes questioned him with them. And straightway all the people, when they beheld him, were greatly amazed, and running to him, saluted him. Mm-hmm. And he asked the scribes, what question ye with them?
Yeah.
And one of the multitude answered and said, Master, I have brought unto thee my son, which had a dumb spirit. And wheresoever he taketh him, he teareth him.
Mm.
And he foameth, and gnasheth with his teeth, and pineth away. And I spake to thy disciples that they should cast him out, and they could not.
Not at all.
He answered him and said, O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him unto me.
Yes.
And they brought him unto him. And when they saw him, straightway the spirit teared him, and he fell on the ground and wallowed foaming. And he asked his father, how long is it ago since this came upon him? And he said, of a child.
Yes.
And all times it had cast him into the fire and into the waters to destroy him.
My Lord.
But if thou canst do anything, have compassion on us and help us.
My Lord.
Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth.
All right.
And straightway the father of the child cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe.
I believe.
Help thou my unbelief. Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
One use for a thought today, only Jesus can deliver you.
Only Jesus.
Only Jesus can deliver you.
Yes.
We see here the story concerning the demonic boy. In other words, he was possessed with a demon.
Uh-huh.
And because of the possession of the demon within the young boy, amen, he was unable to speak.
My Lord.
Praise the Lord. But his father wanted to see a change in his son's life.
All right.
Now this demonic boy was most likely unable to help himself.
Unable to help.
So his father took care of him.
All right.
But I believe the Father came to a breaking point, like they say.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever got to a breaking point in your life?
Yes, sir.
Hey, if you haven't got there, keep living and you'll see what happens. As old people say, keep on living and you'll learn some things.
Yes, Lord.
But I believe the Father got to a breaking point where he just got tired of seeing his son suffering.
Mm-hmm.
And as I begin to, you know, meditate on these words, I begin to think about it. I said, Lord, even within our family.
Yes, Lord.
You see family members going through many things in life.
Uh-huh.
And you just wish that they don't have to.
Wish they didn't have to, Bishop.
And sometimes you feel like, you know, Lord, if I can just do something to help them.
Yes.
You might see them suffering with whatever disease, whatever, might just be stress.
Mm-hmm.
But the key is that, you know, we in the church, we have the solution.
All right.
David realized, amen, that when I can't look to the east, the west, the north, or the south.
Uh-huh. I'll look.
Praise the Lord. I realize that I can look at those places, but what will it profit me?
Yes, sir.
I'm just wasting my time looking to the east, west, north, and south, realizing, amen, the answer that I need is not towards those directions. But David said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills.
The hills, yes, sir.
From when cometh my help.
My help.
Praise the Lord. See, you got to know where your help comes from.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. If you don't know where your help comes from, sorry, because you in a bad state of mind.
Yes, Lord. You're going to need some help.
Praise the Lord. You got to know where your help comes from.
Amen.
And sometimes you may get so at the bottom that sometimes you kind of forget where your help comes from. Is that right?
That's right, Bishop.
Because the storms of life can be rocking you from side to side.
Yes, Lord.
You can be so stressed out, so burdened down, that you can't even think straight.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. It's not that you don't mean well, but you know, amen, sometimes burden just press you down.
That's right, that's right.
Praise the Lord. Something you're trying to, you know, try to keep your head above water.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, tests and trials and, praise the Lord, just tribulation.
Tribulation.
Persecution.
Uh-huh.
Amen. You want to keep your head above water, but you know you just can't do it by yourself.
Yes.
Praise the Lord, but sometimes you just got to sit down and think about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All about the apostles and as they was out there and the waves began to beat upon the ship.
All right.
And water began to seep in the ship.
Uh-huh.
And there they are with all the knowledge of the sea.
Yeah.
Realizing that they came to a breaking point in their life.
Mm-hmm.
That all their experience that they had out there on the Galilean Sea was not able to deliver them from what they were facing.
That's right.
But there the master was.
All right.
Praise the Lord. I believe he got a little tired.
Yeah.
Now let's be knowing that he ain't God.
That's right.
Amen. Because God don't slumber nor sleep.
That's right.
Don't praise the Lord. And God don't get hungry neither.
No, sir.
But there Jesus was tired.
Tired.
So he had to rest. Because he was human.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. I want to say today, yesterday he was a man. And today he's just not a man. But today he's a glorified man. A
glorified man.
Oh, hallelujah. But there they were on the ship.
Uh-huh.
Water coming in.
Yeah.
But somebody remembers and said, wait a minute.
Wait now.
Why are we trying to get through this storm on our own?
Mm-hmm.
Why are we trying to battle this? You know, why are we trying to fight this battle on our own?
All by ourselves.
We realize that ain't nothing we can do.
Mm-hmm.
But somebody, if you let me just use this thing, probably start scratching their head and say, wait a minute.
Yeah, wait now.
Oh, what needless pains we bear.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Why are we just worrying so much?
Worrying so much.
When we know we have the one that we need that is on board.
Uh-huh.
So somebody said, well, I don't know if they said exactly who it was. Maybe Peter, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
But that don't matter to me right now.
It really doesn't matter.
Praise the Lord. What matters is that somebody went down.
Yeah, they remembered.
Praise the Lord. And there he was sleeping.
Uh-huh.
Praise the Lord. Now let me say this. Jesus can't go to sleep in a storm because the storm can't do it no harm.
All right.
Praise the Lord. And sometimes we forget in the midst of the storm who we have.
We have on the inside.
Praise the Lord. Now we forget that the one that promised us, Lord. But somebody went up and began to wake him up.
All right.
Praise the Lord. In other words, Master, if you don't get up,
Master,
you understand? You just might die in your sleep.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. They begin to wake him up.
Wake him up.
They said, Master.
Master.
Praise the Lord. We perish.
Yeah.
In other words, Titanic going down if you don't get up. Praise the Lord. They said Titanic was built in such a way that it was supposed to be unsinkable. Is that right?
Yeah.
But for some reason, somehow, the story is the captain that was at the helm of the ship, he took a break.
All right.
And then he turned it over to another person, but didn't have the experience like the captain did.
All right.
And for some reason, somehow, I believe the ship struck an iceberg. Is that right?
That's right, Bishop.
And the ship began to take in water. I think it was, I believe it had to be about over 900 or something like that people on board. But I know it was more than 50 people.
Yeah.
Was many souls on that ship.
Yeah.
But by the time the captain got back to the helm of the ship, it was too late.
Already too late.
Ship began to take in water.
Uh-huh.
Praise the Lord. And they had lifeboats on there and they was able to get some people off.
Mm-hmm.
But the unsinkable ship began to sink.
Began to sink.
Oh, hallelujah. You know, I think of the old man. Well, the old man back in a few years ago by the name of Elder Napoleon Vine.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hallelujah. He used to sing the song, Ship of Zion.
Yes.
Get on board.
Get on board.
Get on board.
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah. Ain't no danger in God's water.
Mm-hmm.
You can get on board. You can get on board.
Yeah.
Then I heard somebody put the ad this one thing that said, King Jesus
is
my captain.
He's my captain.
Oh, hallelujah. You can get on board. You can get on board. But Titanic sunk. Many souls lost their lives because they thought that the Titanic was an unsinkable ship.
Yeah.
But there was a man.
All right.
Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And this man is the captain of my ship. Praise the Lord. In other words, he's the captain of my salvation.
All right now.
So they went down in the ship and they said, we feel like the Lord don't care about us.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we do sometimes.
Because he don't come to arrest you when we want him to come.
Right,
when
we want.
He don't work it out the time in that we want him to work it out.
Yeah.
So many times we get discouraged. We walk away.
Yes.
Throw our hands up. And then some people even call God a failure.
I know.
Now, as I study the Word of God and I look at myself, ain't no failure in God.
No failure in God.
And ain't no failure in Jesus.
Oh, no.
Now, I want to look at the camera straight, praise the Lord. If there is any failure, it is in the person that is speaking right now. That's me.
That's right, and me.
There ain't no failure in God.
That's right.
So, not because God don't show up when I want him to show up, that means that God is not able.
Mm-hmm.
Them boys said, wait a minute, go ahead and throw us in.
Yes.
We know the God that we serve is able.
He's able.
And just in case,
just in case,
if he choose not to deliver us,
all right.
Jesus got up, look at them. Why y'all so drunk? Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. I believe Sister McCoy often say this, or that folks from down south. What's ailing you?
What's ailing you?
Praise the Lord. They use the down south folks. They'll come up with some stuff. But what's ailing you? What's troubling you?
Yeah, yeah.
What's wrong with y'all? Master got up on the sheep. There the winds was blowing, is that right?
That's right, Bishop.
And you know if the wind is blowing, the waters, amen, gonna be acting up.
Raging, yes sir, Bishop.
But he got up, he looked at the wind. And I said look to the wind. He looked at the force of the wind that was causing the waves and the water to act up.
Yes.
With authority. Praise the Lord. See, when you face things in life, you want somebody that know how to speak into that situation and bring a change in that situation.
That's right.
Jesus stepped up and just said a few words.
Three words.
Peace.
Be still.
Be still. And immediately, there was a great calm.
Great calm.
So the wind obeyed him. Now think about it. None of us can see the wind. And none of us have no power over the wind. But the Savior that we serve, I don't know how, you know, we sometimes we don't realize who we got.
That's right, Bishop.
Praise the Lord. We don't realize who we have as our captain of our salvation, as the head of our life.
Yeah.
Peace. Be still.
Be still.
The wind calmed down. Somebody said that the wind kind of went back. I'm trying to remember the words exactly, man, but wherever the wind came from, it went back and the wind began to behave. Praise the Lord. And the wind stopped acting up. Praise the Lord. And after a while, the waves died down.
Yeah.
Because see, the waves can only act up if the wind is acting up. Praise the Lord.
That's right.
But once the wind stopped acting up, the waves began to behave themselves.
Yeah.
Remember back in the day, somebody give a testimony. Amen. They was experiencing a flood. And the water was coming in. Praise the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But somehow they began to exercise their faith.
All right.
Now, from what I understand, all she had was a little bit of faith. Because you're praise the Lord. And that's the songwriter said, you don't need a whole lot.
Need a whole lot.
Amen. But just you. Just a little you got.
Just a little.
It's better to have a little than have none.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. Because I remember our pastor said, half of a loaf is better than no loaf at all.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. So you may not have a whole lot of faith, but if they got a little bit of faith, that's a grain of a mustard seed, you hold on to your faith.
All right now.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Waters begin to come in.
Yeah.
Oh, I may get the story kind of mixed up or off, which I usually do, but I try my best to keep people's stories straight, but sometimes I mess up. Praise the Lord. But the waters began to come in, and she looked at the water and basically told the water, that's enough, stay where you are.
All right, don't come no further.
Get back!
Yes!
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Some way, somehow, the story came up to say that the water obeyed.
Come no
praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus said, peace, be still.
Yes.
In other words, listen, don't cause fear in the hearts of my children. They belong to me.
Thank you, Lord.
And you will not take their life. You will not drive fear into their heart because fear brings torment.
Yes.
And the Bible said God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love. Jesus said, this ain't gonna happen while I'm here.
Today.
Praise the Lord. You're gonna behave yourself today. Because I'm on board.
Uh-huh.
Those are my children.
All right.
And Jesus said, amen. Then the apostles, they were to come to the realization.
Yes.
They said, what
manner of man is this?
What type of man this is?
Even the wind.
Even the wind.
And the sea.
Because they had never met a man like him.
Never met a man like that before.
Praise the Lord. I don't know what time. Is that salt and pepper? Sing the song, what a man, what a man.
Yeah.
What a mighty good man.
Yeah.
Now, you know, I wasn't always saved, y'all. And all y'all out there that want to act dignified, y'all know some things too. Even right now, some of y'all know some things.
All right, Bishop.
Remember back in the days, I'm coming out of there with a few men. Remember back in the days of our former pastor when, amen, we went in the church band.
Mm-hmm.
Church band was supposed to be playing gospel music.
Uh-huh.
You got in the church band and turned your band on, you got R&B going.
Oh, come on now, Bishop.
So don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about, but I thank God he brought me from a mighty long way.
Mighty long way.
My friend.
Yes, he does.
This father brought his son.
Yeah.
Jesus wasn't there. And when Jesus came back, Jesus saw them questioning his disciples.
Yeah.
So what y'all questioning my boys about? In other words, if you got an issue with me, bring it to me.
Yeah. What's going on?
Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
They said, well, Master, this man brought his son.
Yeah.
And he's possessed by a demonic spirit.
Mm-hmm.
But the father said, I brought him to your disciples to see, can they do something about it?
Uh-huh.
But only come to find out that they could not even do nothing.
Wasn't able to do it, Bishop.
Many people in the world today, I've said before, they're going to the wrong people to get the right answer.
All right now. Talk, Bishop.
Praise the Lord. Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Make no sense. You're on a plane.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to have a little knowledge about how to fly that plane. Why would you go to the flight attendant when you can go to the pilot himself?
Go to the pilot.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Flight attendant may have a little bit experience from being there, praise the Lord. But if they're not licensed to fly, they don't know what the pilot knows.
All right.
So sometimes folks go to wrong people to get the right answer.
That's right.
And then sometimes you got family members. Lord, I'm about to go there. You got some family members sometimes when their loved one gets sick, you know what they do? They go to the witch doctor.
Come on, Bishop.
Oh, hallelujah. In other words, they get their hands dirty.
Mm-hmm.
Witchcraft!
Yeah.
The only reason people go to the witchcraft doctor and to all of these people, I said it before, if you got a relationship with God, you'll never seek out those folks.
That's right.
But once you have a relationship with God, you know what God can do through the Lord Jesus Christ. So you don't go running to the witch doctor.
That's right.
The man said, I brought them to your apostles and they couldn't do nothing.
They weren't able to do it.
Are you going today to the wrong people?
Mm.
Seeking the right answer?
My Lord. Mm.
Today, there is a man.
There is a man.
Oh, hallelujah. Somebody said, well, how is he better than any witch doctor?
Mm-hmm.
Who is he in? Is he qualified? Is he ordained? What can he do?
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you how my Jesus. Jesus is different.
All right,
than any other than folks you want to run and see, you better get me, praise the Lord, Revelation chapter 3, verse 18.
I counsel thee.
Is that Revelation 3?
Yes, sir.
Get me Revelation, I believe it's chapter 1, 18.
1
and 18.
All right.
Get me one of
them. I am he.
I am. Is that right?
That's right.
Not was.
I am.
Not going to be. But as I speak to you right now, John, I am he.
That liveth.
That. Wait a minute.
All right.
He said, I am he. And the I, the one that is speaking, is alive.
That's what he said.
I am he that liveth. You see the difference now?
Yeah, was.
I am.
Yeah.
But I was.
I was.
So was lets me know it's in the past tense.
That's right.
I am he that liveth and was dead.
And behold.
And behold.
I am alive forevermore.
I am alive just not for the day, but I am alive forever. And I have the keys.
Of hell.
Of hell.
And of death.
And of death. The reason why you can count on Jesus, because there is no man.
No man.
That have went to the grave and came back and keep on living.
Yeah.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Talk, Bishop.
Lazarus was raised from the dead.
Uh-huh.
But Lazarus died again.
He had to go back.
Oh, hallelujah. The boy that Elijah raised from the dead.
Yeah. Again.
Oh, hallelujah. Jairus' daughter.
Uh-huh.
Jesus raised her from the dead, yes. But she died again.
He had to die again.
But this man.
This man.
Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That God promised him, I will not leave your soul in hell. Neither will I suffer my Holy One to see corruption. Death will not have control over this man.
That's right.
God raised him.
Raised him up.
Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He said, I have the keys of hell and of death.
That's right.
In other words, I have the authority to free you.
I got it.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said, no man can go in a strong man's house except he first bind the strong man.
You gotta bind the strong man.
You gotta take care of the strong man first.
All right.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And when you finish taking care of the strong man, then you got free reign.
Free reign.
With everything that's in his house.
That's right.
Oh, hallelujah. Y'all know one day, that strong man had me bound. That strong man had you bound.
Had me bound.
We all now that are saved was one day in the kingdom under the control or the influence of the strong man.
Oh, yeah.
But on Calvary.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, I heard a song that sings sometimes. On Calvary. Into Satan's kingdom and freed me. And how did he free me? He translated me from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear son. I'm so glad that I serve a redeemer.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. My redeemer, he
lives.
Somebody say, how do you know your redeemer lives? He lives within me.
Yes, he does.
Yeah. And then I heard that Jamaican song said, don't try to tell me. God is there. He woke me up this morning. other words, God is not dead.
God is not dead.
He's still alive. God never died, matter of fact.
That's right.
You can't kill God, but Jesus is yet alive.
Yet alive.
He lives forever, praise the Lord. He will not go back to the grave.
No, sir. Never again.
He got power to set you free today. Yeah. Whatever got you bound, Jesus can set you free.
He can set you free.
And if the Son, my friend,
set you free.
You free indeed.
You are free.
Jesus said, bring the boy to me. Bring him to me.
Bring him. Bring him.
When the boy father was bringing him, the devil began to act. Because you realize he was about to be dealt with today.
Oh, yeah.
Praise the Lord. Jesus said, you understand? Yeah, you can act up, but I'm in the presence. Stop. Jesus said, now, how long?
How long?
This boy been going through this.
Yeah.
The father said, from a little, from basically from the cradle.
Little child, yes, sir.
Now think about that. Oftentimes, that power, that demon within him, would cast the boy into the water.
That's right.
To drown him.
Try to drown him.
Would put him in the fire to try to destroy him.
Try to burn him up.
Praise the Lord.
My Lord.
But God had a plan. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Many people today should have been dead, sleeping in their grave.
Oh, yes.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm talking about before you came to know the Lord.
Sure.
Now, look back over your life and see.
Sure enough, Bishop.
How many situations came up in your life where you probably overdosed?
Yes.
Where you probably was in a car accident?
Yes.
That's what the Lord showed me from me. He said, many could have been destroyed, but I had a plan for their life. And if there's one that you're looking, talking about, you're looking at one right now.
Yeah, you're looking at two right now.
Matter of fact, if everybody be honest, there's more than two. Praise the Lord. But there I was up in the tree and trying to go get a fruit. And all I heard was a crack.
Crack.
Uh-oh. Praise the Lord. Now, that crack don't mean that limb is still together. That means that limb done, then you know you went up one way,
yeah,
but you're coming down another way. Praise the Lord. Now all I remember now waking up, opening up my eyes, trying to see, all I saw was pitch blackness.
My Lord, my Lord.
But I heard a voice saying to me, close your eyes again and give it a few minutes.
Lord.
And after I did that, I opened up my eyes. My buddy that we went up climbing the tree, he was standing next to me. Praise the Lord. Now, within that area, many times there are broken bottles.
Yes.
Now, think about this. Had I fell on one of those broken bottles, praise the Lord, I would not be here today. You look back in your life and see how God had mercy on your life.
Yes, he did.
God saved your life for a purpose.
Yes, Lord.
God said, I've got a plan for that young man's life.
Uh-huh.
And you ain't going to kill him before my purpose is fulfilled in his life.
My Lord.
But for my purpose to be fulfilled in his life, I got to bring him and expose him to the truth of my word.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
And I'm glad today.
So glad.
I'm alive today.
So glad.
Or real quick, that experience.
Yeah.
I was chased by another man with a machete.
My Lord.
Won't even know if my mother knows this, but she find out today. She know about one, but maybe she don't know about this one. Praise the Lord.
Yeah,
you know, some of us was just some. We just mess here.
Yes.
We just a bunch of mess. And mama don't know everything, is that right? Now let's be honest, praise the Lord.
Yes, you don't know everything.
Some things you just keep hearing from mama.
Yes, Lord.
There I was, me and my buddy should have went and did something we ought to be, had no business doing. Praise the Lord. Next thing we know, boy Ben Johnston had nothing on me. mean, Carl Lewis ain't had nothing on me.
All right, Bishop.
You talking about, you, y'all saying that song, I'm running for my life?
Running for my life, man.
There was a man behind me with a machete chasing me.
I'm running.
Now, I don't know if he was going to beat me with it, because if you skin enough, you can beat somebody with a machete and don't even cut their skin.
Mm-hmm.
But I wasn't trying to find out what you want to do. There I was, I mean, I took off running.
Right now.
And you were swinging that machete behind us. Lord have mercy.
Mm.
God help me to get away from that.
Mm-hmm.
I know my mother done tried to figure out, well, who is this? I'll tell her afterwards if she want to know. But I'm glad God spared my life.
Glad about it.
Think about when you overdosed, my friend. You should have wake up.
That's right. That's right.
But God woke you up.
How did you to wake up? Grace and mercy.
Father said, how long?
How long?
Since from a child.
Yeah.
And look how the devil abused it. Let me say this. Satan will abuse you.
Yes, he will.
He'll take your joy. Mm-hmm. He'll take your peace.
Yes.
Whatever you got that you want to hold on to, that means something to you, that's what Satan want to take.
He want to take it.
You got some joy, he'll find a way to take it. Oh. If you let him.
Yeah.
You got peace, Satan will find a way to take your peace away from you.
Yes, he will.
If you let him.
Yeah.
So don't be ignorant of what Satan's devices.
Oh, yeah.
Because if you don't be careful, you can leave church today.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody can make you mad as a frog.
Mm-hmm.
But when you remember, I will not let the devil steal my joy.
Yes.
Because this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away. Don't let the devil steal your joy.
All right now.
Don't let him steal your peace. Don't let him steal your happiness.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let the devil push you over the cliff. Because if he can't pull you back, he gonna push you over. That demonic spirit control that boy.
Yeah.
That's what sin will do. It will control you.
Amen.
Once sin is in your life, sin is your master.
Mm-hmm.
But once Jesus is in your life, Jesus become what? Your master.
Yes.
Jesus said, bring that boy to me.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take care of this situation today. And when I'm done, this boy is going to be delivered.
Mm-hmm.
When Jesus began to look at the young boy,
yeah,
the devil began to act, the boy began to foam.
Yeah.
I don't know if y'all had experience seeing folks foaming.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord.
Oh yeah.
I've seen folks delivered from demons, and there they are foaming at the mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. Now these little kids now, they wasn't exposed to certain things.
That's right.
But what Jesus faced back then, we saw, many of us saw it in our lifetime.
Oh yeah.
Where people came to church possessed.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen, Bishop.
And I want to say this as I get ready to close out. I don't believe no demons can possess someone that is controlled by the Spirit of God. Praise the Lord. So anytime you see somebody begin to act demonically,
mm-hmm,
they are not controlled by the Spirit of God. The spirit of the devil have them.
Take it over.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But Satan can get in while the Holy Ghost is there.
Mm-hmm.
Cause the strong man had to bind Satan.
Yeah.
Jesus bind Satan and took the power from him and freed all. The devil began to act up. When all that folks saw it, they came running. Jesus said, let me handle this problem real quick.
Yeah.
Jesus said, thou dumb and deaf spirit,
I charge thee. Come out of him.
You see what demons can do? When some people are demon possessed, it can cause them to be dumb. Mm-hmm. It can cause them to be deaf. All demons are not, they all don't have the same assignment. All of them have different assignment. They are from the kingdom of Satan. So when folks don't believe that there's evil, evil is real.
Amen.
And they say in some countries, don't go steal somebody's goat. Because next day, you finish eating that goat. Mm-hmm. You start acting like a goat.
All right now.
Well, y'all don't think these things are real? Mm-hmm. Go mess with some folks' property in some of these African countries. They know how to go to them witch doctor and they'll fix up or something. You know what you know? Huh? You go steal their duck? Mm-hmm. You start quacking like a duck.
Hello.
But y'all think this stuff is just fake? I'm telling you, real stuff.
Hello.
In other words, Satan is real.
He is real.
Demons are real.
They're real.
But they have no power over those that have the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Lord.
Because where there is he that is in us.
And he.
That he that is where? In the world. Jesus said, thou dumb and deaf spirit, read on thee.
I charge thee. Come out of him.
Come out.
And enter no more.
Don't mess with him no more.
No more.
You want Satan to stop having control of you? Let Jesus speak into your life. When Jesus speaks into your life, he has the authority to speak in your life.
Oh, yes.
Jesus said, oh, faithless, I want to bring this in. Oh, faithless, Jesus rebuked the apostles.
How long?
Said, y'all mean to tell me, y'all walking with me, and you don't have a little bit of faith?
How long?
You faithless generation.
How long?
The church should be a place that people must see the difference.
Amen.
People must come to the house of God and experience the power of God.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
But how many churches people can go and experience the power of God because the churches is filled up with the Word?
Amen.
So the power of God is not free to move because what? The Word, the church is living in bed with the Word.
My Lord, my Lord.
There was a time when folks used to come to the church, women wearing lipstick.
Mm-hmm.
And the power. And you will see them, tears running down their eyes,
yeah.
Wiping that lipstick off.
Oh, yeah.
Taking this off, taking that off. Why? The Word of God is what convicts the person.
Yeah.
The Holy Ghost convicts them.
Hallelujah.
But now, folks go to church like they're going to a club.
Any kind of way.
Is that the truth?
Amen, Bishop. Yeah.
You know why they're doing that? Because you got sisters going to church, bust loose.
Amen.
I saw something in my country. I love my country. I love the Assemblies of God. I came out of it. I want to say something. I want you to understand me, all right? There was a time that they didn't allow the sisters to wear pants. I want you to listen to me and follow me. Now I want to say it again. Praise the Lord. I don't believe wearing a pants is going to take you to hell.
No, sir.
I want you to follow me. Mm-hmm. But I believe if the church you're in have a rule, then if you want to be a part of the church, then you got to follow the rule. Is that right? But what I don't want to condemn somebody because they're wearing a jeans, pants, but my wife is wearing night clothes, which bottom is pants. To me, they're both pants. Y'all follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Bishop.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But I believe rules have a place in the church.
Oh, yeah.
But again, if I see somebody wearing pants, in church.
Mm-hmm.
Be free.
Let them be free. Leave them alone.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But if you want to work at Wegmans, mm-hmm. you better abide by Wegmans rules.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In other words, you want to be a part of the Church of Jesus Christ or whatever, whatever the rule is, yeah. live within the rules. Is that right?
Within the rule. That's right.
So if they say, hey, you can work with it, but when you're done, don't go running all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
Change into something else.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how easy is that?
Yes.
I ain't gonna be running all across town.
Mm-hmm.
My tight jeans, all over. I'm talking about saved. I'm talking about all the young ones that ain't saved. They're free from all of this, all right?
Mm-hmm.
But when I look back at my country, and I look at the churches today, the standard don't went down so bad. You got many sisters in the church. You know when they get married, they're allowed to come up with their wedding gowns.
Mm-hmm.
And all their breasts can be out.
Mm.
Praise the Lord. All the new hairstyles that the world come up with, them boys is all into it.
Mm, my Lord.
They got hair longer than some women.
Mm-hmm.
A little leaven leaveneth the whole lump. A little sin leaveneth the whole lump. Today the churches is a mess because there is no standard. And many people want to go to a church where they are free. From all standard.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hallelujah. That's thank right. you, Lord.
That's what they want, man.
And you can't tell the difference between those that are saved from those that are just visitors.
Mm-hmm.
Because the saved one dressed just like the visitors.
Mm-hmm.
I know what I'm talking about.
Amen, Bishop.
Praise the Lord. The guests, visitors coming, breasts all hanging out, shirt skirts. I ain't talking about short over the knee.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about short, what they call it, mini?
Mm-hmm.
Mini skirts?
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. That God forbid something happened to their shoes, they can't even bend down and tie it.
Mm-hmm.
They got a scoop.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. And he was scooping down, they got to be careful doing that. Oh, Jesus. The church should have the answer that the world needs.
Amen.
We have the solution, but what have we done with it?
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
We're supposed to be the light of the world, the salt of the earth, but we done lost our many, done lost their purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
So anything goes.
Anything goes.
You just come and look any kind of way.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. There was a time, I've said this before, certain sisters didn't come up in pulpits and lead testimony service if the line was going.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
They didn't get up in the pulpit with them tight skirts. Ain't nothing wrong looking good. Is that right?
Amen.
But the Bible said, modest!
Modest. Modest.
So a preacher's got to be in the pulpit admiring the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
Just to keep their mind consecrated. Boy, let me look at the lights.
All right.
Up there. Now there.
All right, now.
Praise the Lord.
All right, Bishop.
Oh, hallelujah. Any y'all, is that right?
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord.
The Lord said the church, those that have allowed standards to drop so low. People looking at the church today and say, why should I go there if they're just like me?
What's the difference?
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Why should I go there if they up in the bar at midnight and next morning they're in the choir? Why should I go to that church?
Just like me.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And some out there is so they got a little bit of fear of God that they refuse to come to God's house and be a hypocrite.
That's right. That's right.
They said, no, I don't serve in the Lord. You understand? You got to be real. And I'm coming over there faking the funk.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna be real if I come there. I'm gonna dedicate my life to the Lord and serve Him in sincerity and in truth. I wanna come to the house of God and play church.
Amen, Bishop.
Now you got many players in the church today. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Play boys and play girls. How many want to live sanctified?
Thank you, Lord.
You want the Lord power to be made known in your life. Live a sanctified life.
That's right.
You want to experience the power of God. Live a life of holiness. Yeah. Dedicate your life to the Lord and forget about the world. You will experience the power and the deliverance of the word of God.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And you can go on your knees and pray for your family.
That's right.
And God will hear your prayers.
He will answer your prayer. Yes, sir.
The man said, Lord, Jesus said, if you believe,
you believe,
it's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
The man with tears. Think about that father with tears.
Yes.
Burst out with tears. Said, Lord,
I believe.
I believe. Jesus healed the boy.
Yes.
They thought the boy was dead. But when Jesus got through with him, he was clothed and in his right mind. When Jesus gets in your life, you will have a right mind.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen, Bishop.
Only Jesus can deliver. It's easy, my friend. It's easy to do wrong.
Yeah.
Very easy. But it's a challenge to do right. Because Satan will not leave us alone. He will do all he can.
All he can.
To make us do wrong. I shared something with my wife, and I shared it with you all. The Lord said the reason why sin and disobedience is rampant in the church and in the world, because iniquity shall abound, the love of many,
wax cold.
If more people love the Lord the way the word of God say, you ain't gonna have all this problem today. That's what the Lord showed me. He said, your obedience must base on your love for me. And Jesus said, if you love me,
keep my commandment.
You will keep my commandment. The reason why the church is in a mess today, there is no true divine love for God and His word.
Thank you.
But when you love the word of God, when you love God more than your brother, more then you love God's word more than your takes a stand, the power of God will be made known.
That's right.
Yokes will be broken. Deliverance will be wrought.
Yes.
We will see the power of God. My prayer is, Lord, help these to live so that the power of God may be manifested through me.
Thank you, Lord. Bless them, Lord.
I don't want to play this thing.
No.
Yes, we might have played sometimes. But listen, when God clean you up and give you a second chance, you better run for your life. And you said, I might be a mess back there, but I got to clean up when I messed up.
Mm-hmm.
And I ain't going to be a mess by the grace of God no more.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I want to live right, walk right, act right, talk right, that the power of God will be seen in me.
Thank you, Lord.
I said, Lord, I want to live for your glory. What I preach and teach, I want it to be for your glory.
Your glory.
That's my request. That's my prayer. Lord, let me preach and teach and live for your glory.
Right. That's right, Bishop.
Yes. Nothing else.
Yes.
May God bless you.
Thank you, Lord.
Have a smile upon you. God give you peace. Is our prayer.
Thank you, Lord.
Turn over to Jesus. Turn it over to Jesus.